case you have made an error, how can you do this? So from here again, we can create another table. We can have more than one table in the same database, but we can't have two databases in one database. So let us create another table. Maybe we call that table T-shell. So we can say create, then we give that table name T-shell. So I can open the bracket. Now you asked me, what if I made a mistake when I'm creating a table, like in the fields, and I've made a mistake, how can I do that? So let me just press enter there from there, and this is T-shell ID. And we say this, we can make an int, because I said int is 11 by default. So even though I don't give the word 11, it is okay. And so this is it, not null. And we say this is in our primary key. And this primary key is auto increment, comma from there. And then I proceed. Then I can have T-shirt name. And say this can be Vasha. Now you asked me, what if I have made a mistake? So how can I do that? So I'm just going to use one and I do a mistake from there.
No, if I've done a mistake like somewhere like here, and I've reached here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's do that very same mistake. And then we see how we can do with that. Do we need to go back and we start writing it afresh, or what can we do? You get it? I'm going to make a mistake from this T-shirt name, and I just proceed from there and say not. Yeah, by not giving the numbers in the version. So let me just say that not null comma. Then I press enter. Then I press, and this is a T-shirt, so salary. And this can also be in version. This version. And if this is in 100, I'll say this is not null. Let me just stop from there. And then we terminate. So I said in terminating, we can either press enter from there, and we also terminate from here. It is okay. So if I press enter, we are having an error. Now this error we have made from T-shirt name, which is in Vasha, and it is not null. We did not give the value for
so
that.
They have to say the error here.
Yeah, you have an error in your SQL. So check manual that correspond to your MariaDB server, where they say that to use near not null between this not null on line 3. So this is our first line, this is our first line, and this is the second line, and this is the line 3. So in this line 3 we are having between not null. If you check on line 3, we are having this between this Vasha and not null. There's something missing there. You get it? So how can we do that? If you go to your key on this keyboard here, you are seeing this word V up here. Here, this V. If you click that V, will take you to the first point here. I see. But if you press this one again, if you press it again, it will take you to that first one. It takes you to the first one. So what you need to do, click it again, or click down, click it again, and then you click the word create table. Start from there.
That's V up.
Yeah, that's press enter. Click up again, create table, then click down to T-shirt. I see. Then click enter. Click up again. Just click here up again.
We just click
up. Yes, up, then click down. We have T-shirt name. Then you can go and you change that. As this is it, maybe you give the value you want to give. You get it? Then go back, press enter, click up again, and click, and then you can look for the last one.
So you keep on clicking that.
Yes,
you keep,
you keep on clicking
until everything appears.
Yes. So in this command, you can't just correct one. You have to go from where you started. But with this key, it will help you. Instead of you typing afresh, you just click on this and you get all the information you made in the process. So we have this. teacher's salary, then we shall click that, and then we click the last, then we press enter. So from there we shall have very okay, the row being affected. So if we type show tables, we shall have our two tables from there. And if we try to disk, so we say this is the same as describe. So describe the table which is in teacher. And if we terminate, we shall have that information from there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now do I need to open another shell?
Okay.
Does
so
minimize this? Then I open the other one. I open another one.
We can open another one. How do we save this information? You come straight here. Click on this. You get?
Mm-hmm.
Click on edit. On edit, go to select all. If we select all, we highlight everything from here. Click on that. It is highlighted. Click up again. Click on edit. Then click copy. So you are done with the copy. Then you can go and then you create your folder. You can go to the folder. Then maybe you can use this text document. You can call this CMD and then you can click inside and we paste our information from there. Control S to save. Then you can, and that's all.